Is leaking your IP address really dangerous? It seems like many people think so, because when I released my Minecraft hacking video series, I kept leaking my personal IP, as well as many other players. Oops, sorry. After that, I got tons of worrying messages telling me about it. I should immediately remove it. But how bad is it really? I believe it's not bad at all. And my suspicion is that the crazy amount of VPN ads manipulate people into believing it is dangerous or bad. So in this video, I want to investigate this danger of leaking your IP address. And at the end, I will also tell you my recommendation on what you could do instead of a VPN. As always, these are just my opinions on the matter. The devil is in the technical details. So feel free to challenge my views and discuss with others in the comments. This video is sponsored by nobody. Of course, I wouldn't advertise a VPN in this video. Sorry, I had to do that. Anyway, where do we start? In theory, IP addresses are unique and identify a computer on the internet. For example, a Minecraft server address. This part is the IP. It identifies the computer, so where to find the server on the internet. And this is the port. The port is then used on that computer to find which program you want to communicate with. In the case of a Minecraft server, it's the Minecraft server program. On the same computer, you could also host a website, and then the web server program would be accessible on maybe port 80. But we want to focus on the IP address. As you can see, IPs are supposed to be addresses for devices on the internet, and so they are inherently public. For example, I didn't release the IP address of my Minecraft server, and still people found it, because it's easy to scan all IPv4 addresses on the internet. And that's our first lesson. How much can you even hide your IP? If there's anything insecure about your device, if you really believe a hacker can hack you when they know your IP, you are screwed anyway. People will find your device regardless. But don't worry, not only are modern devices generally secure, you have another layer of protection you might not know about. Yes, my Minecraft server is directly accessible via an IP address, but as you probably have heard, we don't have enough IP addresses for all devices on the internet. How did we try to solve that problem? You can see it here. I have two phones connected to the same Wi-Fi, and I look up their IP address. Both phones have the same IP. And this is very common for residential internet connections. So the IP does not actually identify every device. It's just the address of the device directly connected to the internet. Usually at home, this is your router. Which means this single IP does not point to your device, it points to the router. And behind this address, there could be dozens of devices. And in a larger shared flat or a college dorm, hotel, or in an office, maybe several hundreds of devices and different people use the same IP. This is achieved through NAT. It's an interesting technique and quite clever how routers translate packets and forward them to the correct local device. There are also some very interesting weaknesses in NAT which get exploited for good reasons, like UDP hole punching for playing games, or for bad malicious reasons like NAT slipstreaming. But that's not the topic of the video. The important part is that the IP address is shared by many devices and often shared by many different people, which has legal implications. If you have roommates and you commit a crime, they don't know who exactly committed the crime. Was it you or your roommate? Depending on your local laws, maybe this means they cannot prove who committed it and you are safe, or maybe both of you get raided, or by default they are charging the owner of the Wi-Fi. Check your local laws. But besides the legal trouble, point being, your public IP address, the address website owners and Minecraft server owners see, might be used by many different people. So this is the second lesson. The same IP does not mean it's the same person. Of course, if you live alone, things might be different and you don't have this legal protection. However, some ISPs have started to deploy DS-Lite. It's very common in Germany. This is when IPv4 is tunneled over IPv6, leading to another layer of NAT, or carrier-grade NAT, which means behind this public IP, there might be hundreds of customers, each of them with dozens of devices. And don't forget, lots of people use the internet through LTE. Here, your mobile operator also probably shares IP addresses for many connected devices. So even living alone, your public IP might be shared by many, many people. On top of that, it's very common when you restart your router, or it happens automatically every 24 hours, the IP address you get assigned by your ISP changes. So from the point of view of a website operator seeing your IP, they don't know if it's exactly you, and the next day you might have a different IP anyway. But of course, all of these things depend on the ISP, and probably every country has different behavior as well, so the best thing for you is just to test it yourself. Also, I've read in the comments on the Minecraft video that there are a few people that actually have a static IP, though usually that requires a special contract or a business contract, and I would guess those people know what they are doing and know why they want a static IP. By that I mean they want a static IP so people can know the static IP. And then if you worry about people knowing your static IP, don't get a static IP. Of course, there are also people who had no choice for a static IP, but then again, what exactly are you worrying about? We will get to these threats in a moment. But for most people, the IP address changes regularly and it just identifies the home router or a router of your ISP or mobile operator. So leaking an IP address doesn't really mean much. There could be literally hundreds of people behind that IP. This actually creates a lot of problems when blocking malicious IP addresses, because if you as a website owner block an IP, you might accidentally block a whole area like a hotel or office, so blocking hundreds of people from using your service. Anyway, now that we have covered some important properties of IP addresses, let's talk about the impact of leaking IP addresses. What's the threat model? I see two areas, hacking or attacking IPs and the more privacy concern. As you can already tell, if you leak the IP address of a person, the IP address could mean different things. It could just point to your router of the ISP or it could point to your home router. And attacking the home router might be the most risky case because you might have an outdated router with some exposed services or default credentials that could be hacked, or it can be directly targeted for a denial of service attack. So maybe you feel worried about your unsecure router and think that it's a good reason why you need to keep your IP private. But keep in mind, all IP addresses are public. There are not that many. You can literally scan the whole internet in like half an hour, and malicious hackers constantly scan the internet for vulnerable routers to take them over. So if there is a known exploit in your router might already be hacked. And if not, then maybe your ISP knows about the issue and blocks these attempts on their end. So security issues are not really a concern. And if it is, you need to fix the root issue. Security through obscurity, aka trying to hide your IP, doesn't fix it. However, maybe you don't worry about security issues, but about denial of service attacks. It's easy to overwhelm a basic home router. But as I said, in lots of cases, the IP doesn't even point at your home router. At this point, an attacker maybe DOSes the ISP directly. And keep in mind, it's just a DOS. It might knock you off the internet temporarily, and for some businesses or streamers, this has economical consequences. But that's all there is. Go outside, touch some grass, and when you come back, maybe it stopped and you can continue. You have no actual loss of privacy or security there. It's not hacking. And maybe a restart your router gives you a new IP anyway. But are there other privacy concerns? VPN companies always advertise protecting your privacy by hiding your IP. But as we already learned, in lots of cases the home IP is already achieving the same. It's also public IP shared by many other customers. So from the point of view of the internet user who sees that IP, you're already kind of obscured. But of course there are some differences between a VPN and an ISP, so let's go through them. The probably most important difference is the legal jurisdiction. Depending on a country's laws, ISPs might be required to keep logs on which customer was using what IP. So when law enforcement wants to find your real identity from an IP, they can ask the ISP for it. This is definitely a risk if you intend to break those local laws. But actually, this is the same for VPN companies as well. They might be required by their local laws to do the same. So it really depends on what jurisdiction you live in and what level of crime you committed. Of course, a VPN is a second layer that might shield you from basic legal investigations because they operate in a different country than where you live or your ISP is located, but laws exist to protect both ways. Not only do laws allow police to request information about an IP, there are also data protection laws that protect how that data is used and when it has to be deleted and so forth. So if you use a VPN registered in some weird ass country where your national police has a hard time to get the data from, yes, you're probably safe from legal investigations, but maybe the privacy laws of that VPN's country are so bad that they can happily log all the websites, inject ads, create profiles, and sell all the data to advertisement companies. It's hard to say what in practice really happens, but in the end, you have to trust them. So I personally prefer to route my traffic through my local ISP, where I also have legal power and rights that I could defend, versus routing my traffic through a shady shell company who tells me with ads I should trust them. But I don't want to fearmonger too much, because ultimately most connections are encrypted thanks to SSL anyway. So in my opinion, the privacy risk is not that high, and for the legal risk, that depends a lot on what crime you commit. But as you can see, in the end, it all comes down to trust. Where do you want your packets to travel through? Do you trust your ISP more or the VPN provider more? You have to make that decision yourself. Also, I think it's important to not forget what it means to have a privacy issue. I mean, privacy issues arise when you share private information. So what private information does your IP leak? If you use Facebook and Instagram to share private photos, it doesn't matter if you use a VPN or your regular IP, you still share your private photos online. So the actions you do online are much more important than the IP. The only thing the IP leaks is your location, but this is a bit misleading because what do you mean by location? It doesn't leak your exact GPS coordinates. It might point to the city you live in, but most likely it points to the region where tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of people live. Of course, some might want to completely hide their general location and don't want anybody to know they live in Berlin, but I don't think this is generally an issue most people have to care about. Think about normal people. They post a single picture on Instagram from hiking near their home and people could figure out their general location. So let's talk about me leaking the IP addresses of players on my Minecraft server. How bad was it? In my opinion, some of those IP addresses are dynamic and changed long before I uploaded the video. And some of these IP addresses are shared with hundreds of people anyway. Of course, it might leak the rough geographic location of some players, but maybe they don't care or they leaked it in many other ways. For example, oh my god, here I leaked the famous automated IP address. Because I'm so famous, he came onto my server. Now we can geolocate him too. Seattle. Oh my god. But on his GitHub he also says he lives in Seattle. But besides all of that, are you ready for my last argument why me leaking the IP addresses of players on the server is not bad? If one of those players really really cared about hiding their tracks online, being super paranoid, they must have used a VPN to access the server anyway. As you can see, in my opinion, there's no meaningful security risk or meaningful privacy issue about leaking IPs. There are crazy edge cases with very weird threat models where this all can matter, like whistleblowing. I agree, they exist, but they will have to deal with those threats on their end, because their threat model probably doesn't include trust nobody except this dude LiveOverflow, so I directly connect to his server. If your threat model is cannot trust anything I connect to online, then don't connect to it. Don't use your home IP, whatever you consider your home IP. Okay, anyway, now many of you watching probably also screamed the whole time, is he talking about IPv4 or IPv6? And well, yeah, most of what I mentioned mostly applies to IPv4, due to them running out and many customers will share IP addresses, leading to the ISP setups discussed in this video. With IPv6, the game kind of changes. And to be honest, I'm not super sure how ISP setups look like with IPv6. The little bit of networking knowledge I have is mostly limited to IPv4. But I guess depending on your internet setup, your device might actually be directly accessible from the internet if the IP is known. So suddenly leaking the IPv6 of a device could mean that an outside attacker has direct access to your device, and not like with IPv4 where an outsider attacker only sees your router or your ISP's router. So I think that could be an issue. And to be honest, I personally rely a lot on IPv4, DS-Lite, NAT, and routers in general being my firewall. No clue how effed up IPv6 maybe is. But this whole video was motivated due to the comments on me leaking IPv4 addresses, so well. Anyway, in the beginning of this video, I also promised to share what I use if I have to be anonymous online, and that is Tor. When I have the use case to really hide my internet connection, I will use Tor. Tor is probably the strongest and most reliable tool you have for internet privacy. But of course, you have to use it right. You always have to think about your threat model, because while you are very anonymous, the Tor exit nodes can be operated by anybody and they will log traffic and collect data, maybe even manipulate traffic. But that's the same power your ISP or VPN provider has. So it is generally a threat model you should operate within if you care about that kind of stuff. Luckily, you have SSL to encrypt actual data transmitted, so in practice, it's not super risky. Anyway, those were some thoughts I have on the danger of leaking IP addresses and why you shouldn't fall victim to the fear-mongering of VPN providers. Of course, there can be legitimate concerns about leaking IP addresses, which some of them I mentioned, like streamers, DDoSing, but hopefully you see that in the most general case, it really doesn't matter. But if you are one of those edge cases, try to really define your threat model. Don't just blatantly use a VPN because it makes you feel safer. What exactly are you protecting against? And then think about what are the most effective measures against it, which of course is only possible if you actually try to learn more about networking. But maybe that's a good motivation to learn some IT stuff. And of course, check the comments. I'm sure there are people who share their opinion and mention technical nuances I maybe forgot or didn't explain correctly. So probably that's interesting as well. Thanks.
While I was editing the video, malware researcher OALabs released a related video titled "Your VPN Sucks for Malware Analysis." I really recommend you check it out because it provides a very unique perspective about the topic you probably haven't heard before.